Detained former Senator Leila de Lima slams the Philippine National Police for barring several personalities from visiting her on her birthday last weekend. De Lima admits they filed a visit request only on August 22nd, days short of the required 10-day prior notice. But De Lima insists the policy should not be an inflexible rule. De Lima claims the discretion of approving authorities was imprudently exercised. Now she adds, this also caused another unnecessary ruckus, just like the visit of U.S. congressional delegation earlier this month. Senator Risa Ontiveros, former Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, and former Ombudsman Conchita Carpio-Morales were among those who were not allowed to visit De Lima. The former senator has been detained since 2017 at a facility inside the compound of the National Police Headquarters. She's facing several illegal drug charges, which she claims were fabricated.
The Philippine National Police and the Justice Department give different reasons for blocking the guests of detained former Senator De Lima during her birthday. DOJ spokesperson Mico Clavano says a court order is needed to visit De Lima. Clavano cited the case of the U.S. congressional delegation, who were only granted visitation rights after they filed a motion. De Lima's camp, however, refutes this, emphasizing that no court approval is needed under PNP guidelines. As for the PNP, it maintains that De Lima's visit request was submitted late, making no mention of a court order.
And families of human rights victims known as desaparecidos in the Philippines remember their loved ones on the eve of the international observance of enforced disappearances. Rights groups believe such cases only worsened during the presidency of Rodrigo Duterte. Bianca Dava reports.
Leia was a high school student when her older brother disappeared in 1988. At the commemoration of the International Day of Disappearance at the Bantayog ng mga Bayani in Quezon City on Monday, Leia could not hold back tears as she recalled the day her brother was abducted.
Meron pong apat po na sasakyan noon ng mga armado po sila. Yung time po noon, sinusuyod po talaga yung mga aktivista sa amin, malabo na botas. Bali po talaga si Kuya is, ano po talaga siya, aktivista na yung time na martial law, victim din po siya, isa rin po siyang inano ni Marcos noong time na yon.
Leia's mother died without seeing her son again.
Buti na lang po sana kung nakita namin siyang wala na. Meron po kami pagsisindihan ng kandila at dadalawin po sa sementeryo. Pero sa nangyari sa amin, hindi namin alam kung nasaan siya.
As of June 2022, the families of victims of involuntary disappearances or fined has documented 2,520 victims of enforced disappearances nationwide. The highest number of disappearances was during the administration of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. with 1,022. This is followed by the number of incidents recorded under the administration of former President Corazon Aquino at 825. There was a decline in the number of victims during the administration of former Presidents Fidel Ramos and Joseph Estrada, with 80 and 64 cases, respectively. Under the administration of former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, there were 353 victims as a result of her all-out war against communist insurgents and terrorists. Under former President Benigno Aquino III, FIND recorded 32 desaparecidos. The group, meanwhile, documented 144 cases of missing persons during the term of former President Rodrigo Duterte.
Kada administration patuloy yan. Even yung sumunod, Cory, Ramos, Erap, Gloria, even panahon ni Pinoy at saka hanggang kay Duterte. Kay Duterte, may political activist. Ang nabago sa panahon ng Duterte ay yung mga biktima ng war on drugs.
FIND Acting Secretary General Louis Crismo's brother Romeo is also a desaparecido. Romeo, who worked as a teacher in Tugagaraw, Cagayan, was 24 years old at the time he was abducted. Crismo said enforced disappearances still persist in the country, either as an administration's way to instill fear or as perpetrators' way to evade persecution.
Noong panahon ng martial law, ano ba yung pinakikipaglaban ng mga winawala? dahil nakikipaglaban pa sila para sa hustisya, kalayaan at demokrasya. Pag binangga mo yung mga nasa kapangyarihan, ang natural na magiging reaction ng mga nasa kapangyarihan ay supilin ka, takutin ka, supilin ka sa pamagitan ng pagpatay, pag-torture, pag-detain sa'yo. May resistance, may repression. The more yung resistance, the more yung repression.
The Philippines Republic Act No. 10353, or the Anti-Enforced or Involuntary Disappearance Act of 2012, defines the term as the arrest, detention, abduction, or any other form of deprivation of liberty committed by the agents of the state or by persons acting with authorization or support of the state, followed by the concealment of the fate or whereabouts of the disappeared person, which places him outside the protection of the law. However, the Commission on Human Rights said the law is not properly enforced.
Bagamat nagkaroon na tayo ng anti-enforced disappearance law noong 2012 at ipinagmamalaki natin na ito ay pinakauna sa Asia, nananatiling nagaganap ang kaso ng mga sapilitang pagkawala, patuloy na nagaganap, bunga ng pamamayani ng kultura ng impunidad o ng kabiguan na mapanagot at maparusahan yung perpetrator.
The human rights groups and families of victims of involuntary disappearances challenged the administration of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to reveal the truth behind all enforced disappearances, uphold due process and the rule of law, fully and strictly implement RA 10353, and end impunity and injustice.
Nabaliwala yung kasaysayan na may mga pangyayaring kanon. Sana huwag i-deny itong mga human rights violations na ito. Natotoo namang mga nangyari. Aminin yung mga pagkakamali at gumawa ng mga pamamaraan pa upang matigil lahat ng mga violations na ito.
Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News. Ano, nakita natin.